The Karen Beasley Sea Turtle Rescue and Rehabilitation Center is dedicated to the rescue, rehabilitation, and release of all species of sea turtles. The Turtle Hospital is only one of a handful of fully equipped marine veterinary hospitals in the country and is committed to the care and release of sick and injured sea turtles, creating a protected environment for sea turtle nests to ensure hatchlings have the greatest chance for returning to the sea, and providing data to North Carolina Wildlife Resources regarding the numbers of sea turtle nests. In loving memory of her daughter Karen, the Turtle Hospital was founded by Executive Director Jean Beasley, the 2013 Ocean Hero Award winner. This February, the hospital opened their doors at a new location in Surf City, North Carolina. Though the new digs came at a cost of approximately $1.5 million, the most significant equity comes in the form of sweat. Hundreds of volunteers have put in thousands of hours of physical labor and materials donation. So why go to all the trouble and expense of rehabilitating sea turtles? Perhaps we need to consider how vital the sea turtle is to the Earth's ecosystems. They are the eco-engineers that fine-tune our oceans and beaches, keeping populations of aquatic flora and fauna in balance. Green turtles are herbivorous and feed on seagrass, keeping the plants in check so that the grasses don't become too dense, which promotes disease. The negative effects of diseased patches of grass would be felt by other species, such as drum and sea bass, which rely on the grass shelter for protection, and manatees and urchins, who eat the leaves of the seagrass. At another level, the algae and organisms that live on the leaves are forage for other animals. The leatherback turtles feed on jellyfish, keeping populations in balance. Without this balancing mechanism, jellyfish populations would increase exponentially, thus consuming larger amounts of fish larvae, which in turn would contribute to oceans with considerably fewer fish, thus impacting all species that rely on fish as a food source. Hawksbills forage on sponges in and around coral reefs. If these turtles ceased to feed, sponges would overgrow and choke the reefs, which are habitats for countless marine organisms. Sea turtles also support the health of our beaches. Sand is a granular substance that holds very little nutrients. Thus, the dunes and grasses rely on energy from turtle eggshells, as well as the eggs that do not hatch. The eggs bring a source of food to terrestrial fauna. All seven species of sea turtles, the leatherback, the hawksbill, loggerhead, green, Kemp's Ridley, Olive Ridley, and the flatback, are endangered species at risk of extinction. In just the last century, numbers of sea turtles have dwindled. It is estimated that 1 in 1,000 sea turtle hatchlings survive, and only 1 in 10,000 make it to adulthood. They are an indicator of our global health. The potential extinction of the sea turtle is an indicator that our planet is in trouble. These issues related to the environment affect each of us in our daily lives, and we need to become more fully educated as to how we can provide for our planet's ecosystem. Come join me on a journey with the sea turtles who were fortunate enough to be washed up on Jean Beasley's shore.
Everybody's scared to decide to take that step.